You read endless reviews. You finally find the telescope you want to order. You whip out the credit card and you start ordering. Now you get to wait, as the delivery service takes forever to get your package to your door. Once he pulls up in your driveway, you calmly walk out and greet him to get the package. Finally, it's here. But now what do? This is going to be a quick unboxing and assembly of the Geisker 130mm EQ mount reflector telescope. So here we are opening the box, checking out the instructions such that they are. The reason I'm opening this is it seems thicker than just a sheet of paper. Indeed, it's folded and it's in two different languages. But other than that, not a whole lot. Inside the bag is also a small cleaning cloth and an Allen wrench. So start opening the small boxes. Here we have the first of the counterweights. We have our slow motion controls and the counterweight bar. This will be the second counterweight. This is our mount. Most of it is metal. There's some plastic on it. It's nice to see it mostly metal though. Here's the leg assembly. Tray. Leg assembly is all put together. This is our eyepiece tray. In this little box, we got lots of stuff. First up is our phone mount. Eyepiece. Another eyepiece. And another eyepiece. And another eyepiece. And that is our finder scope holder and our finder scope. No idea what that is. Here's a telescope. Now you need to be careful here because I didn't notice that both of the rings are loose. So you might not want to pull it out the way I did. I just scoop the rings off, pull the plastic off, get the box out of the way. And then there's the telescope tube and the brackets. So twisting the lever on the legs, I can slide the legs out. Here we go. Legs are fairly stable. So now we'll put the eyepiece tray over here. Attach the mount using the screw from underneath. It's the first time you do it. It takes a really long time because it's completely unthreaded. Now, here what I'm worried about is the top of the telescope going past the top of the video, so I'm going to shorten it a little bit. Make sure you can see everything I'm doing. So next, I'm going to put the telescope rings on. Now, some telescopes, the rings and the bar are separate. In this particular case, it's already assembled. That's a nice little feature. Make sure everything's tight. I'm going to take the optical tube, place it in the rings, slide it over, and tighten them up. So now I'm looking at this to see if there's other stuff I need to assemble before putting this on, and I didn't see anything. So I'm putting the finder scope on at this point. Fairly straightforward. Counterweight bar in, which turns out to be a mistake. I had assumed that the bolt on the end would come loose, so here I go after some pliers. It did not want to come loose. So rather than force something, I just took the bar out, and I'm going to put the counterweights on the bar and then attach the bar. Except I dropped it. As you'll see in a later video, it turns out there's a bar, a little aluminum bar that's in there. I had to slide out of the way. So now I'm putting that little aluminum piece back in. And then the tightening knob. Snug them up pretty good. And reattaching the bar. Now what I'm going to do is do a quick level. Quick balance. Not overly concerned, I'm just trying to get it a little balanced so it's easier to work with. Yeah, it's still a little off. Close enough. Maybe not. Okay, once again, checking to see what order they want you to do stuff. I noticed that I'd missed one of the clips when I put on the eyepiece tray. So I'm readjusting that. Okay, so now slow motion controls. Not really sure why I look back at the instructions at that point. Slow motion controls is pretty straightforward. Checking everything out. Ta-da!